Welcome, and see how fast and easy it can be to design user interface elements in pages. I will show you how to create a button that looks like a keyboard key, using three of the coolest features you can find in pages. Start by creating a rectangle matching the color of your target background. Then create a black rounded rectangle. This is a hole where your button will fit. I suggest you set the exact size in pixels using Inspector. Duplicate the rounded rectangle and make the new copy a little smaller. This will be the border of your button. Now the first cool feature comes to the scene. It's called Gradient Fill. Gradient Fill is probably the easiest way to mimic the 3D effect of light and shadow. Then create another copy of the rounded rectangle and make it smaller again. This will be the button's top surface. Simply reverse the gradient and make it a little softer to shape the surface properly. Make sure to adjust the rounded corners to reflect the different size of each layer. Add a text label to the button and you're almost done. To make the button look really cool, create one more layer and utilize the other two cool features. Advanced Gradient Fill and Opacity. Using a circle gradient, starting from a fully transparent white on the border and going to a partially transparent white in the center, will add a nice shine to the button. Voila! You have a cool, realistic looking button. To get it out of pages in a suitable format, you can use Preview. Copy the button and the background to clipboard and create a new document in Preview. This may sound tricky, but you have to first save the document as PNG with 72 pixels per inch in order to be able to edit it further. Now you can use the Instant Alpha Selector and remove the background. Crop the image to the button size and save again. Now you can use the button in FileMaker Pro, an iOS application, or anywhere else